Hi everyone, and welcome to the channel. In this video, I'll be looking to grow some aloe vera, and in typical Jimmy B. Harvest style, we'll be trying to do it with Kratky Hydroponics. Aloe vera is actually a succulent and doesn't really require that much water, so attempting to do this with hydroponics really intrigues me. I've got a pre-made kit that has an aloe vera seed somewhere inside of here. It claims we only need to add water. I emptied the contents of the kit trying to find that aloe seed, but was unable to do so as it must look very similar to this grow medium. I poured all of those contents back into this cup and hoped that the aloe vera seed was in there and somewhere near the top. By day 10, I had a small plant emerging from this soil. We really got lucky that the seed was up near the top and the plant was able to break through. I let this plant continue to grow. Here we see it at 21 days of age, and I'm gonna take this opportunity to try and move it into a hydroponic setup. I'm doing my best to be gentle here and graciously move this soil away from the plant so I'm able to pull it out. You can see just how small this young plant is. We got one small leaf and three small roots. I'll be using this grodan cube to help support the plant and wick moisture around to the roots. I'm sliding this plant in from the side so that I'm not applying any unnecessary pressure to the roots. Moving this grodan cube into a net cup and adding some clay pebbles up around the top to help prevent light leaks from getting into my reservoir. We want to ensure our grodan cube is partially submerged in water so that it's able to wick that moisture around. I'll be adding nutrients into my reservoir and moving this plant into some light. In week 5, I discovered that mold was beginning to grow on my rock wool cube. Because this plant and its roots are so small, I'm forced to keep the rock wool cube moist at all times, and this is a prime situation for mold to develop. I was able to remove the plant from the rock wool cube, but it still had mold spores on it. I was hesitant to use any sort of disinfecting chemicals on such a young plant, so I simply moved it into a new rock wool cube. That mold continued to reestablish itself on all of the new grodan cubes that I used. It wasn't until the plant became larger and well established with its root system that I was able to not use a rock wool cube at all and simply have those roots fall down into the reservoir. That took an incredibly long time. This plant is 6 months old here, and we still don't have a leaf that is 3 inches long. Aloe vera grows incredibly slowly, but there's always a new leaf coming out from the middle, and I think this plant is doing okay. In month 7, I harvested a leaf from this plant for use in other content on the channel. I wanted to see if the aloe vera gel inside could help us to propagate plants faster. Aloe vera gel is rich with salicylic acid, which has a number of benefits and has been proven in academic studies to help improve plant rooting. This aloe plant is still quite young and small, and harvesting this leaf might have been a bit premature. Nonetheless, the plant rebounded quickly, callusing over the area where I made my incisions, and the plant continued to grow as normal. We rejoined this plant in month number 9, and it's still growing slow and steady. That said, the leaves of this plant have started to show some spotting. This is typically a sign of too much light or too much water, and it's possible that this plant doesn't like the hydroponic setup. Maybe a more likely culprit is this re-emergence of mold. You can see on my root system here, I've got mold developing, and this is going to need to be cleaned up. I removed the plant from the original net cup and thoroughly hand washed the roots in warm water. Once I felt they were clean, I moved them into a new net cup with new clay pebbles. Now that the plant was a little older and more well established, I thought it would be okay to use a disinfecting product to try and get rid of this mold for good. I'm using hydrogen peroxide here and spraying it all over the roots and the lower parts of this net cup. After spraying the plant, I would dip it in tap water to try and rinse away the hydrogen peroxide. Here we are in month 10, and you can see I've added some tin foil to the outside of this reservoir. I've done this to prevent light from getting inside and allowing algae to grow. Our root system is looking much healthier these days, and we seem to be staying mold-free. We've even got some new roots developing. Up near the neck cup, you can see some small, very white roots, and the plant has just put those out. I opted to give this plant one more round of the hydrogen peroxide treatment, trying to keep it as clean as possible. We rejoined this plant one more time to celebrate its first birthday. Could not be more excited that this plant is still alive. I'm not convinced that this plant is loving the Kratky hydroponic setup. It's continuing to see leaf spotting, particularly on this one leaf, which has a number of dark spots on it. The rest of the leaves have small spots up around their tips, but no major spots along the thick parts of the leaves. I'm adding less water to my reservoir these days to ensure I'm not overwatering this plant. Time will tell just how big this plant is able to get. In a lot of my hydroponic grows, I've seen pristine white root systems. That's just not the case here, but this plant continues to put out new roots. I've decided to cut off some of the roots which are dark brown and are possibly suffering from some root rot. And this is where we'll be ending episode 1 of my hydroponic aloe vera grow. I'd love to hear what you guys think of this grow, or if any of you have grown aloe vera or other succulents in a hydroponic setup. It's definitely not normal, but it's been a fun experiment for me, and I'm excited to see what this plant does next. Thanks a lot for watching, and as always, happy harvesting!